Yeah, hello there. Today, something completely different. I wanted to talk about a tool called Autohotkey, which is for Windows, but there is also similar stuff for Mac. I not only use Bitwig, I also use Reaper and Cubase for different tasks. Bitwig is my main DAW, but it lags a bit on audio cutting side. So for that, I still use Cubase, and for recording, always Reaper is still the best because the software is running in 2 seconds and you're ready to record. And what drives me totally nuts is when the keyboard shortcuts are different between those programs, because you should absolutely learn keyboard shortcuts. Keyboard shortcuts make all the jobs much faster you can do in a DAW. Yeah, you can configure in all three DAWs keyboard shortcuts, but you will run in some limitation. For example, in Reaper and in Bitwig, some keys on the numeric keypad are broken. You totally know when the guys are developing that who don't use a German or French or whatever keyboard, then you run in stuff like that. So there is a way to fix that. If you use AutoHotkey, you can, for example, use it also to start your programs with it, so you can assign shortcuts for everything. For example, I have assigned all an editor is on Windows key, shift key plus T, so you have your editor ready very fast. What you need to do first is you need to install AutoHotkey, which is a very, very small software, and you can download it here from www.autohotkey.com and simply grab here the installer and install it. And this allows you then to run AutoHotkey script. It's also full-blown programming language, so you can also write complete GUI-enabled programs. But its main task is for doing, as the name implies, some hotkey manipulation, also mouse stuff you can do. It's very nice controlling windows, starting programs, and all that stuff. This is an excerpt from the AutoHotkey script I use all the time, so it's always automatically started when I start Windows, so I have all these shortcuts available. So what I did for Bitwig is, as I said, there is a problem with the numeric pad, so you cannot map, for example, the dot or delete key, which is the same key, depending on the numeric key is on or off, and I actually want to behave this like it behaves with Cubase, so if you press that key, you get to the start of the program. So I simply said, if it's Bitwig, so this is a check for the Bitwig windows, if the Bitwig window is active and I press that key, I want to execute the home key, because to the home key there is a feature assigned to go to the start of the project. Another thing that drove me nuts is when I opened up the performance window, you can assign a key to that, but you cannot assign a key to close it, or it does not close it automatically. So what I did is, if the performance graph window is open, I said, okay, if I press then the escape key, close the window, or if I press F12, which I assigned to opening it, also close it. So if you see, I cannot press F12 and press it again, it goes away. Or I can use the escape key, it also goes away. So this makes some stuff much faster. You don't have to grab the mouse and you can stay with the keyboard. Same thing here with Reaper. I also assigned the same problem here with that key I assigned to the home, and also the diff key with Reaper is broken on the numeric pad, so I want to assign that to the L, which toggles the loop in the arranger. With Cubase, there's also something, the export window does not close when you press the escape key, and there I did the same trick with closing the windows. And I also use another software, so Camtasia is what I use for recording here my video podcast, and it also has a timeline and the navigation, but the keys are completely weird compared to all other DAWs. So I did a lot of replacement of keys here, so you can also use it like you used to the Cubase numeric pad assignments. So quick little tip, and maybe it comes in handy for some people, and it's absolutely worth digging into that software a bit. It's really simple to learn, and you can do a lot of copy and paste and don't have to be a good programmer or anything. As you see, you basically just write check for a window and say, I want to change a knob, or I want to start something. Also, if you run the software as I did, it's also very simple. You just say, for example, I press a Windows key and the shift key and the P, and then I start, for example, a graphic editor, or I start Firefox and stuff like that. And it's really, really handy and speeds up your workflow massively. So until next time, do some funky code.